Do subscribe to Ikeda channel and press bell icon to get updates about latest engineering, HSE and IIT JEE main and advanced videos.
Hello students, it is very important to describe an equation that could relate the colligative property and the concentration of a solution. So let us start with the relative lowering of vapor pressure and related to that a equation. So as on your screen you can see that we are now going to express a relation between lowering of vapor pressure when a non-volatile solute is present in it. So will it be lowered or will it be higher? So let us see. Suppose I have a solution which has two components, that is A and B. These components are usually solute and solvent, and in this thing multiple solutes can also be present. So let us consider only two components, that is A and B. With a mole fraction of XA, which is for A, and XB, which is for the B component respectively, and consider here B is a non-volatile solute, so it will not raise or it will not contribute its vapor pressure to the whole solution. Let us see further. So now let the vapor pressure of pure component, that is A, be P naught A, and for component B let it be as P naught B. So since P naught B has no contribution to the total vapor pressure, so the contribution of P naught B or the vapor pressure of the solute which is a non-volatile solute will be zero. Therefore, according to Rawls' law, that we know that the total vapor pressure is equals to P naught B plus P naught of A minus P naught of B into XA, where XA is the mole fraction of pure solvent. So, because in this case the P naught B has no contribution, I have taken the value as zero. So, therefore, I will substitute the value P naught B here. So, ultimately, the value of P naught B will be zero. And again the P naught will be the same, P naught A will be the same, minus again it will be zero, and by doing this equation we'll get a final equation as the above. So the total vapor pressure of a solution will be the product of vapor pressure of pure solvent and mole fraction of the pure solvent or the component A. So, but also we know that the lowering of vapor pressure is denoted by delta P, and delta P is nothing but P naught minus P, where P naught is vapor pressure of pure solvent and P is the vapor pressure of solution. So now in this case we have elaborated an equation for a solution only, the lowering vapor pressure of a solution only we are talking about. So therefore we'll substitute the P total value in P. So we'll get P naught minus P naught of XA. So P naught bracket 1 minus XA, and this 1 minus XA is nothing but XB. How? Because XA plus XB is nothing but 1. So therefore 1 minus XA is XB. So delta P divided by P naught, I have taken the P naught here. So this expression is nothing but lowering of vapor pressure, relative lowering of vapor pressure. And now we have derived or we have equated or we have given an expression that relative lowering of vapor pressure is related to or has a relation with XB, that is mole fraction of solute. And hence relative lowering of vapor pressure is dependent on the number of solute, and hence it is a colligative property. So this is the equation that we should remember, so that this equation will be useful in the next derivation. So thank you friends for watching this video. I hope you have liked this video, and please don't forget to subscribe ikeda.com. thank you so much.
Fir se thank you so much.
Thank you students for watching this video. I hope you have liked this video and please do share with your friends and subscribe egra.com. Thank you so much.